First, I'd like to thank my colleague from Georgia, Congressman Andrew Blythe, for introducing this legislation. It's extremely important to always protect every single American's constitutional rights. Gun rights are an American right, and they belong to all of us, and they should not be taxed. So thank you so much for that. It's extremely important, and I hope more of our Republican colleagues will talk for this great piece of legislation. I'd also like to talk about the Senate Gun Control Bill. I'm very disappointed, extremely disappointed, in Republican senators who led an effort in their chamber to attack the Second Amendment rights of Americans. And this was supposed to be their response to the Uvalde massacre, which we're still all in shock over and mourning each of those families. This was not a response to that. You want to know what it was? What it is, it's a continual sellout to the establishment. It's a Republican sellout to Democrats who want to take away Americans' guns. Now, the reason why I can say that is because as a teenager, when I was a student in high school, in 1990, one of our students brought guns to school, and our entire school went on lockdown. That was in 1990, I want to remind you, when Joe Biden, then Senator Joe Biden, made all the schools gun-free school zones. And since then, for 32 years now, we've seen school shooting after school shooting. Now, it's really interesting to me that these Republican senators come out with this horrific gun control bill, attacking Americans' Second Amendment rights, supposedly to do something about this gun horrible tragedy that happened in Uvalde, but they ignore the fact that the person that went into Buffalo wrote in their manifesto the reason why they chose that location is because they have strict gun control laws. Republican senators are making Americans less safe by taking away our Second Amendment rights. And I want to tell you what they've come up with. In this bill, it has a boyfriend loophole. Now, don't forget, we just went through a whole debate because Democrats can't define what a woman is. So how are they going to define what a boyfriend is? It's absurd. In the language of this bill, they can turn it any way around, anyone with a relationship. It's very wide open. Another thing they're giving, Senate Republicans and Democrats together, Mitch McConnell, by the way, is giving an unlimited amount of funds to Medicare. It literally has a blank line. There are no numbers there, ladies and gentlemen. It is a blank check to Medicare in the Senate gun control bill. How is that going to stop or change anything? It's not going to. You know what else they're doing? They're giving $100 million to the FBI. Who are they going to be pursuing? Parents that are trying to hold their school boards accountable? I don't think they'll be pursuing the people protesting and harassing Supreme Court justices. But what about the domestic terrorists that are attacking pregnancy centers across America? I don't think the FBI will care about that. Now, they're going to be going after legal gun owners' weapons, and they're going to be funded by Republican senators. Here's the problem I have. Joe Biden, then Senator Joe Biden, that made my school a gun-free school zone and has left American students like sitting ducks, targets for anyone that wants to go kill them. He's friends with these Republican senators, and I'll tell you soon who they are, because I don't mind naming their names, because people all over our country were furious at them. Senator Blunt, Senator Burr, Senator Capito, Cassidy, Collins, Cornyn, who got booed off the stage practically in Texas, Ernst, Lindsey Graham, who promised me just a few years ago that he would not violate due process rights for red flag laws, broke his promise. Mitch McConnell, complete failure to Republicans. Murkowski, Portman, Romney, Tillis, Young. These are Republican senators that Republican voters do not support anymore. We've got to change our Republican Party, and it needs to happen right here. Because if we don't start defending Americans' freedoms and rights and putting America first, our Republican voters are not going to want to put us in charge. We need to do a better job. The Senate gun bill is a complete failure, and I'm so happy with our House GOP leadership saying that they're voting no against this bill and whipping against it. That's something I am extremely pleased with, and I know Republican voters and independents and gun owners, period, are going to be thrilled with. So thank you for joining us today, and I would like to turn this over to you. We're here from California.